Hello, I welcome you all in the YouTube channel Civil Engineering. Now, in this lecture, we will be learning about the brick masonry. Brick masonry is a highly durable form of construction. It is built by placing bricks in mortar in a systematic manner to construct solid mass that withstand exerted loads. The bond in brick masonry which adheres brick together is produced by filling the joint between the bricks with suitable mortar. Special cautions shall be practiced while mortar is mixed and placed since it greatly affects the performance and durability of the masonry structure. Now here you can see what actually is brick masonry. Characteristics of good building bricks. It is always desirable to use the best quality brick in construction. Therefore, the characteristics of good brick must have to be investigated. Generally, good bricks possess following properties. Bricks should be uniform in color, size and shape. They should be sound and compact. They should be free from cracks and other flaws such as air bubbles, stone nodules, etc. with sharp and square edges. Bricks should not absorb more than 1/5 of their own weight of water when immersed in water for 24 hours, that is 15 to 25% of their dry weight. The compressive strength of the bricks should be in the range of 2000 to 5000 psi, that is 15 to 35 mpa. The presence of excess soluble salts in the brick also causes efflorescence. The percentage of soluble salts, that is sulfates of calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium, should not exceed 2.5% in the burned bricks. Bricks should not change in volume when weighted. Bricks should neither be overburned nor underburned. Generally, the weight per brick should be 6 lbs, that is pounds, and the unit should be less than 125 lbs per cubic feet. The thermal conductivity of bricks should be low, as it is desirable that the building built with them should be cool in summer and warm in winter. Bricks should be non-inflammable and incombustible. Bricks should be free from lime pitting. Bricks should be soundproof. Now, classification of bricks. First, that is first class bricks, second class bricks and third class bricks. Now, in first class bricks, specifications are plain surface, sharp edges and the size with tolerance in dimension up to plus minus 3%. Uniform red or brownish colored, high crushing strength not less than 10.7 Newton per mm square. It should be machine molded, efflorescence should be nil and water absorption should be less than 15%. Uses. They are used for exterior wall brickworks, short columns and arches. Second class bricks. Slightly uneven faces and edges with tolerance in dimensions of plus minus 8%. Uniform colored but may be slightly overburned. High crushing strength not less than 7 Newton per mm square. It may be hand molded. Efflorescence may be little and water absorption should be less than 20%. Uses. They are used for internal walls and compound walls. Next, third class bricks. Its specifications are, it may be distorted with the blunt edges, overburnt or underburnt and non-uniform color, high crushing strength but not less than 3.5 Newton per mm square. It may be hand molded, efflorescence large and water absorption should be less than 25%. Uses. They are used for flooring, paving, small brick and foundations and brick bat lime concrete. Now in this picture you can see these are the first class bricks, second class bricks and these are nothing but third class bricks. Now types of bond. The most commonly used types of bond in brick masonry are stretcher bond, header bond, English bond and Flemish bond. Now further we will see the description of each of these bonds.
Brick masonry. In this lesson, the learner will be able to define brick masonry, list out the types of bonds, explain the construction procedure for different types of bonds. In the ancient period, people constructed buildings with the help of stones and lime mortar. But shifting the huge stones was a very tedious process. As the sledges were pulled by a team of laborers and the tracks were kept waxed in order to reduce friction, slowly people started to use the lightweight bricks and cement mortar for the construction of buildings. For purpose of constructing, different types of bonds are followed. Brick masonry is built with bricks bonded together with mortar. For permanent buildings, lime or cement mortars are used, but for temporary sheds, mud mortar may be used. Now, let us discuss about the bricks and different types of bonds in brick masonry in detail. The general size of the modular brick is 190 mm by 90 mm by 90 mm. Let us learn about the different dimension of a brick. This is the stretch of face. This is the head of face. And this is the half queen closer. Brick laying process can be done perfectly with the brick professional equipment. In the following images shown on the screen, you can see the vertical plane guide, the horizontal plane guide, the mason mate, and the pro pointer. Let us now discuss the process of making cement mortar. The preparation of cement mortar is done in the ratio of 1:3 for grade M7.5 cement. That is, one bag of cement for three bags of sand. Add water to the cement whose ratio is 70% of the weight of the cement. For one brick thickness wall construction, start the construction by first laying the head of face. Keep two bricks each at one end by placing the cement mortar below it. Temporarily fix the mason mate and tie a thread at the top corners as shown on the screen. Place the cement mortar by using the vertical guide. Finish the header row and place the cement mortar above it with the horizontal guide. Continue the same process for the stretcher row. The various types of bonds generally used in brick masonry are stretcher bond, header bond, English bond, and Flemish bond. In stretcher bond masonry, all the bricks are arranged in stretcher courses. In the header bond brick masonry, all the bricks are arranged in the header courses. English bond courses consist of headers and stretchers. In the Flemish bond, each course comprises of an alternate header and stretcher. In the stretcher bond masonry, all the bricks are arranged in stretcher courses. However, care should be taken to break the vertical joints. Originally, it was used for half brick thickness walls. In the header bond brick masonry, all the bricks are arranged in the header courses. This type of bond is useful for the construction of one brick thick walls. English bond courses consist of headers and stretchers. This is considered to be the strongest bond. Hence, it is the commonly used bond for the walls of all thickness. In the Flemish bond, each course comprises of an alternate header and stretcher. The alternate courses start with a stretcher and a header. Let us summarize what we have learned in this lesson. Brick masonry is built with bricks bonded together with mortar. In stretcher bond masonry, all the bricks are arranged in stretcher courses. In header bond brick masonry, all the bricks are arranged in the header courses. English bond courses consist of headers and stretchers. In Flemish bond, each course comprises of an alternate header and stretcher.
Now, as seen previously, this is the pictorial view of stretcher bond. Here, in this picture, you can see all the stretchers are facing on the wall side. This is header bond. Here you can see all the headers are facing. This is English bond. In this type of bond, alternate layers of header and stretcher are being laid. Now this is the alternate layer of stretcher and this is nothing but alternate layer of headers. In this Flemish bond, you can see alternate headers and stretchers are played in every layer of brick. Thank you.